We're here with Elizabeth Eno in Orlando, Florida at Wycliffe Bible Translators. She just took us on a wonderful tour of the building, and now I'm going to ask her some questions. So what are you up to now?
My role for Wycliffe is a discovery trip coordinator. Basically what that involves is interviewing students who are interested in serving overseas long term, and you want to get a glimpse into what God is doing around the world through Wycliffe. So I interview them, get them ready to go, do pre-trip orientation with them, and then coordinate their whole trip, everything from how they're going to get there, whether that's a plane, a train, a bus, a rickshaw, a camel, and then where they're going to sleep, what they're going to eat, but then most importantly, what they're going to be doing on the field. And usually that is something that our missionaries or our national staff on the field have asked us to help them with. So a specific project that they need help with for 5 weeks or 3 months, the length of the trips is different depending on what the need is and what the student has time to give. So my role is kind of overseeing all of that and also leading the trip. I'll be leading a trip this summer back to South Asia where I've been before. So I'm really excited about it because I'll be able to help others get to the field and get to these places where God's word hasn't yet been translated, and so they'll be able to help with that process, and that's exciting to me.
Now you have someone special going with you.
Yes.
Tell us about it.
His name is Jason, and he's my husband. We just got married in November. So he currently is a school teacher, an elementary school teacher, and he's very good at what he does. And he also has a Bible school, a Bible club that meets at his school. He has about 80 to 90 students every week that come out for that. And he has never been on a missions trip.
Elizabeth is planning a discovery trip to South Asia, and it's my first mission trip, so never been overseas on one, so I'm a little nervous and excited at the same time.
How long are you going to be gone?
About 5 weeks.
5 weeks. You have your trip ready to go.
It's in process, so as I'm planning it, I'm also interviewing students to go. Our deadline is like mid-March to sign up for this trip. I'm working with the students, and I'm also working with our field staff to, you know, line up even language. A big part of the trip is language and culture learning. So, you know, it's kind of a trip to mimic what a first month maybe on the field would look like. If these students were going to serve overseas long term, what would their first month look like? This is kind of what it would be. It would be language learning. You do that from day one. You do culture learning from day one. So we focus a lot of time on that as well as the hands-on experience too.
What's it cost?
This trip is about $5,000. It includes the international airfare as well.
And you're raising money for Jason?
Yes, we are raising money for Jason. I do want to say thank you to Columbus West Church of God for your support and your prayers for me for so many years. I am thrilled to have you partner with me, and Jason is going through this process. He's learning what it's like to invite other people to partner with him as he goes, and because it can't go alone. So yeah, he is raising prayer and financial support as well.
Okay. Anything else you want to tell us?
Thank you for praying for us. You can pray for the trip, this trip to South Asia, just all the logistics, all the ins and outs of, you know, it's kind of like a puzzle, fitting pieces together. And for the students who are going, for many of them, this is a next step, a very serious next step to their walk with the Lord and their journey towards serving overseas. So someone had told me, you know, what if you live in the States, you need to multiply yourself. You need to, if you're not going to be overseas, you need to get other people to go overseas. So I just feel very privileged that this is kind of a part of that, being able to send people over and to go with them and train them and watch them go through this process. So prayer for that, and prayer for Jason and me too, that we continue to pray every day and grow together and learn what God wants us to learn during this time.
Well, thanks for your time, Elizabeth.
Thank you.
And we'll keep praying.
Thank you.
Share the well, share with your brother, share the well, my friend. It takes a deeper well to love one another, share the well, my friend.